I've been chilling, watching the ocean with you. Hey guys, it's your girl Tiffany, and welcome back to my channel. If you're enjoying my journey in getting to know the group called TXT, please remember to hit that subscribe button. Hit that bell because it lets you know when I've uploaded a new video. Just go ahead and like the video. Even if before you even finish watching it out, just like the video. It's okay. Just like the video. And leave your comments in the comment section. Let me know what I should watch to get to know TXT. Okay, guys. So we are finally getting into, if you've watched my previous videos, I've done the guides in getting to know the personalities of TXT. We are now getting into their debut song, which is Crown. Now, before we get into the reaction, I just have to address something that came up, and I didn't know if I should take that person. I didn't know at the time if I should take that person seriously, but I'm addressing it just in case there are anybody who is watching my music or watching my reactions and thinking like that person. So I'm gonna let you guys know that the rant begins now. I'll also put up the above if you don't want to hear the rant, where to skip to in order to get into the reaction. So in Yunjun's baby guide, which was a helpful guide in knowing TXT, they did such a great job. The first video gives you what you can expect from TXT song wise and I made the comment that their first two album is giving me a childlike vibe from the snippets I've heard. This is what I said. From the snippets I've heard that they put into their introduction, I'm getting a childlike vibe. Now this person decided, I'm going to be honest with you, it was one of the most unnecessary rants I've ever seen in my entire life. It was so unnecessary. But it dawned on me when I first told one of my friends, who is what I think you guys call multi-stans, who enjoy a lot of groups that's in the K-pop community. She warned me that you're gonna find fans, and then you're gonna find those that just, no matter what you say, they feel like it's their responsibility to be overprotective. And I was thinking, well, that will more happen if I say something out of pocket. I'm sure people out there will understand that just because you enjoy a song don't mean necessarily someone else is going to like it. Well, I think I was wrong. I thought that's how people operated. I may have been wrong. So I say this because this person put on the, again, unnecessary rant, saying that I'm dissing TXT because I use the word childlike. And the rant told me three things. Didn't comprehend what I was saying. It definitely, because their arguments had nothing to do with what I stated about TXT. It had nothing to do with it. Two, they don't understand the difference between childish and childlike. And three, they just wanted to pick a fight. That was all they wanted to do. So there is a huge difference between childlike and childish. One, childlike simply means a purity, a sweetness, an innocence to it. Childish is immaturity, that someone's being a brat. So, for example, if you go to Disney World and you're over the age of 18, you're gonna get a childlike feeling from Disney World or Disneyland. But that don't make you childish to go to Disney World or Disneyland. If that makes sense. So, me saying that their sound, the snippet songs, sounded childlike was not me saying that TXT is an immature group. And then they brought in their lyricism. No way or shape or form in my review of the snippets that they used did I say that their lyrics was subpar. So I didn't understand them bringing up. They try to make, oh, their lyrics is way more deep. I'm like, I know that. One, because I went to their fourth album. So to understand what they were saying in Korean, I had to look up their lyrics. So I already know their lyrics are good. So I didn't understand them bringing up the lyrics part. They then went on into saying that, oh, the reason why you're calling them, you're dissing them is because you're not used to happy songs or upbeat songs. Again, comprehension is not that great, I see, because how are you using that as an argument? Because you don't know me. I've never told you the type of songs or songs that I like. So for you to tell me I don't like happy upbeat songs, it's you just picking a fight because you don't know what I listen to. And then they went on to say, oh, I'm comparing them to Kid Bop's songs. I'm like, that never came out my mouth. You're misconstruing something. What happened is you didn't understand the terminology and you ran with it. You just ran with it and made that up. Because never once have I said TXT wants to sound grown. Never said that. I said I appreciate TXT because their music seems to mirror whatever age they're going through. And that, I feel, is a great thing. Because I hate when 17-year-olds have songs and it sounds like it should be made for someone who is 30 years old. So, I don't understand the Kid Bop's comment. And for me, it was like, this is what you're getting upset about. Me using a term that you seem to not understand. And it was just like, that was such an unnecessary thing. And I'm like, so I say this to say, basically rant over, basically I'm saying this because I don't want to get into that. And I'm telling you right now, if you bring unnecessary comments into my comment section, I'm going to delete it. I'm going to block you from coming onto my channel, comment section. And I'm hoping the person who wrote that comment is seeing this, and no, don't come back to my video. I appreciate every view, every comment that everyone give, but if you're coming simply to dislike or simply because you don't understand something and want to pick a fight, I don't have the time or energy to give that to you. So I just want to put this out there. If you feel like I've said something and you want clarity, leave it in the comment section. I will either clarify it in the comment section or I will clarify it in the next reaction. I'll give you the time. I'll take a time out of my reaction just to answer your concerns. And I didn't think that I needed to say this, but it seems that I do. Just because I may not enjoy a song that you enjoy thoroughly does not mean that the group is a bad group. I can't believe I'm saying this, but it seems like I need to say this going forward. And I think I might have to say this going forward on any music videos or music that I'm going to listen to. Just because I dislike a song don't mean it's a bad song. It's just simply not my taste. Okay, guys? So, that being said, rant is over. So, I just wanted to just clear that. Let's clear the air going forward. So, we are going into TXT debut song, which I know is called Crown. We'll be right back. That was an interesting first verse. Not first verse, but first line. Let's go back a little bit. It says, "Your whole staring at me blankly in the mirror is not me." Wanna run away, wanna disappear. That's a tough line, because I think every person has gone through that, where they look in the mirror and the person they see doesn't reflect what they feel about themselves. So that's a tough line to say, and that's a self-aware line as well. Who I am, I don't know who I am. Abracadabra. Again, the magic thing. Stop this stuff. So are they asking themselves that question? Are your wings the same thing as mine? Okay, okay, I think I'm getting this. The concept. Actually, I'm still a little worried. I'm standing in between the cold snare and the lonely. Okay, that was an interesting lyric. The lyrics was very interesting for this song. Okay, let's go straight into the music video, and at the end I'll discuss what I thought I understood from the song. So we're going into the music video. Big hands. I love the effect they use in. Oh, the haunts are coming up. I love the haunts animated. The choreography is clean as well. They use a lot of isolation. That was a clean video. So I want to commend Big Hit before I go into the song for not making TXT like BTS, because they could have easily go through that route where TXT is like BTS, because no matter what TXT does, they will always have that comparison because BTS is their label brother. So I appreciate that Big Hit didn't give them the same song, didn't give them the same choreography, because they seem to do more ISOs while BTS still has that hip-hop kind of flair to it. So I appreciate that. Now, the lyrics, the reason why I watch the lyric videos, because there will people be like, but it has lyrics in the music video. The reason why is because for me, I'll be more interested in a music video than what they're actually saying. So I thought it would be best to watch the lyric video just to get like an understanding of what the song is about. From my understanding, from what I think that I understand about it, it's terms of growing up, because the most profound line was the first line of how they started. The person that I see in the mirror doesn't seem like it's me. So they don't recognize who they're seeing in the mirror. And that could be taken in terms of they don't see their growth. Or it could be terms of seeing low self-esteem. Because let's be very honest, everyone has gone through a point in their lives where they look in the mirror and that's not who they think they are. That person is completely different. I don't know that person, but that person is me, but I don't recognize them. I just want to know the symbolics of the horn. Is the horn that grows up my head, it becomes my crown? Is the horn acceptance that, yeah, I'm going through some trials, some tribulation, but I need to embrace that side of me? Is that what the horn means? Because that was interesting, because they're saying the horn becomes their crown. So what they're trying to allude to in that? But definitely it's a song of growing up. It's a song of leaving, I guess, your teenage years to becoming a young adult. And everyone goes through where they don't recognize themselves sometimes. And sometimes you feel like the world doesn't understand you. The world is gonna judge you for what you think is a flaw. So that's what it said, the loneliness and the snare is coming, because they feel like no one's gonna understand your pain. No one understands me, because I myself don't understand what I'm going through. So it was an interesting, the lyrics didn't match the music video. And I did say in a previous video, I love when music videos does that it doesn't match the lyrics, because the lyrics are dark. They're really dark. Yeah, the lyrics are dark. It's dark. There's nothing to try to lighten that up. It's dark. I love that it felt fresh. That was the music video. Reminded me. It seemed fresh. It didn't make the boys up to be anything that they're not. I love the fact that the music video itself was, I'm going to use the term plain, but because they used the animation and the different effects that they had, it made the music video fun. But the choreography, as I said, it's very clean so far from what I'm seeing. And that's the debut music video, the debut choreography. It was very clean. Again, I said they more do isolations than anything. It seems like isos is their go-to choreography. And I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the lyrics. I feel like there's maybe something deeper that I missed. So let me know in the comments what you took the song to mean. Because I'm still trying to figure out what the horn represents. And what did you first think of the music video when you saw it? So let me know in the comments what you thought about TXT Crown. With that being said, if you enjoy my reaction, please, minus the rant, please like, hit that subscribe button, and leave your comments in the comment section. I'll see you guys in the next reaction. Bye.